From Nashville, Tennessee, the Grand Ole Opry, starring George Morgan.
The moonlight was fine, for a while you were mine. I gotta go, I can't be slow, it's been nice, real nice. A sweet girl like you needs a lover who'll be true. I ain't the one, I just have fun, it's been nice. Well, hey, 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 be gay, I cannot stay, don't waste your tears on me. Young girl, have no regrets, but just forget we met in a midnight whirl. Your love burned like fire to melt my desire. Before I go, you gotta know it's been nice. Well, hey, 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 DJ, I cannot say, don't waste your tears on me, young girl. Have no regrets, but just forget we met in a midnight world. Your love burned like fire to melt my desire. Before I go, you gotta know it's been nice. Thank you very much, and a great big howdy to all my good friends and neighbors of the Grand Ole Opry.
And this is just about the biggest night we've ever had here on the Opry, ladies and gentlemen. As usual, you'll hear such favorites as Rod Brasfield, Minnie Pearl, Moon Mullican, String Bean, and all the gang. But what makes tonight's show so outstanding is our guest star. George Morgan, tell the people who's come to see us.
Well, friends, I'm just an old country boy from Waverly, and I don't have a lot of highfalutin words that this wonderful lady ought to have for her introduction. But I can tell you this, the Grand Ole Opry will never have a warmer welcome for a warmer person. She's a great singer, a great personality, and most of all, she's a great human being. She's Miss Helen Traubel. Let's make a welcome.
That's the most highfalutin welcome I've ever had.
All right. Well, we're sure proud to have you down to pick and sing, Miss Traubel.
Well, as Minnie Pearl would say, I'm just so proud to be here.
Yeah.
Now that we've got that out of the way, where's that little fella from Hohenwald, Tennessee?
Well, I'll tell you, he's right here, raring to go. Folks and Miss Traubel, here is the Ruberosa, Rod Bradsfield. Here he comes.
Well, thank you, men, for the fine music. Thank you, and howdy, Mr. George Morgan. By Ned, I'm glad to see you.
Hiya, Rodney.
Yes, now, before we go any further, I want to give you the weather report for tomorrow.
All right, what's the report for tomorrow?
High winds, followed by high-blowing skirts, followed by me.
Hey!
By Ned, I'll do it, too, you know? Yeah. Howdy, friends. It's been a pretty day here today, though, ain't it?
Oh, it has. Listen, yeah. Rod, they tell me you had quite an argument with your gal Susie's daddy last night.
Susie's daddy?
Yeah,
that old booger. You know what he done?
What did
he do? Kicked me right in the stomach.
No.
Yeah, he did.
Why'd he kick you in the stomach?
Well, I guess it was my fault, George. I turned around.
Well, I would have.
But I tell you, I still like the old boy. Yes, sir, I like him. Yesterday, I went to him and I says, look, I want to marry your daughter.
Yeah.
Will you say the few words that'll make me the happiest man in this world? And by Ned, he said them.
What did he say?
He said, stay single, boy, stay single.
Well, look, I don't blame you for wanting to marry Susie, Rod.
No?
She'd be a beautiful girl if it wasn't for her receding chin.
Receding chin?
Yeah.
Oh, Flitter, George. She ain't got no receding chin.
Well, I know she has.
No, she just looks like that because she's got a protruding face.
Oh.
Well, look, Rod, if you love Susie so much, why don't you just elope with her?
Elope with her?
Yeah.
I asked her to elope with me once, George, and she says, I'm afraid I can't elope with you, Rod. I want a man with get up and go.
With get up and go?
Yeah. What she said.
What'd you do?
I got up and went.
Well, look, before you get too far away, Rod, I want you to meet our guest star.
Yeah?
She's the famous opera star, Miss Helen Trouble. Miss Trouble, this is Rod Brasfield.
Why, how do you do, Rod?
Well...
I'm telling you, I'm just glad to see you, Miss Trouble. I sure am. I tell you, you know it's a funny thing. It's a small world, ain't it?
Oh, it is indeed.
Yes, ma'am, it's a small world. I used to sing in the Opry Michelle.
You did?
Yes, ma'am.
In what opera did you sing, Rodrigo?
Well, I sung in the Marriage of Figaro.
What role did you sing in the Marriage of Figaro?
I sung First Shotgun.
All right. Do you know Madam Butterfly?
Do I know Madam Butterfly? Well, Lordy mercy, I've known her ever since she was just a little cocoon.
A great treat for you.
Yes, ma'am.
I have 2 tickets for the opera tomorrow night. Would you like to go?
Well, now, I'll tell you, Miss Trouble,
Well, now, they're having Verdi's Rigoletto.
How's that?
I said, they're having Verdi's Rigoletto.
Uh-huh. I thank you, ma'am. That's mighty neighborly of you, but I'll tell you the truth. That their Italian food just don't agree with me.
Well, then, perhaps you'd like to sing an aria for me right now.
Yes, ma'am, I'd love to sing for you, Miss Trouble, but I've been practicing so much here lately, I've strained my voice. The doctor told me to cut out my singing.
Why did the doctor tell you to cut out your singing?
Well, one reason is because he lives right next door to me.
You know what, Rod? I don't believe you can even act, much less sing.
Oh, I've done a lot of acting. Yes, ma'am. Now, you take Romeo and Juliet. I played the part of the father.
Yes, yes, ma'am. I know that part.
You do? And in Midsummer Night's Dream, I think my upper plate missed out on that. In Midsummer Night's Dream, I played Puck.
Oh, yes, I know that part, too.
And in 3 Men on a Horse, I played the horse.
I know that part, too.
Yeah. I played...
but it's a pleasure, me.
Oh, much obliged.
Oh, I'm telling you, George Morgan, the folks sure do go for Helen Trouble and Rod Brasfield.
Yes, sir. Sort of like pipe smokers go for Prince Albert smoking tobacco. Hey, Grant?
Exactly. You see, pipe smokers like a natural-tasting, smooth smoking tobacco. And Prince Albert suits them perfect. Prince Albert is tobacco just as nature meant tobacco to be. Crimp cut, mild and tasty, mellow all the way.
And PA's fine flavor stays put, too.
Yes, due to a special process perfected over a period of nearly 50 years, that aged in goodness Prince Albert's so proud of is held and heightened for extra pipe pleasure.
Another thing, fellas, the gals enjoy having PA's light, clean aroma around.
Yes, nature, in her own sure way, put the flavor in PA. So, men, make your next pipe full Prince Albert, the national joy smoke.
My daddy once told me that the way to really get to know and appreciate music was to listen to all different kinds of music. I guess Miss Helen Trouble and Dad would get along just fine, because Miss Trouble believes in all kinds of music, too. She's sung and been a big star in every type from Grand Opera to Grand Ole Opry. And tonight, her first song on the Opry will be Fred Rose's fine ballad, No One Will Ever Know, Miss Helen Traubel. Miss Trouble, I'm telling you, Miss Trouble, if you ever learn to pick a guitar, we're all dead here at the Grand Ole Opry. Oh, that was terrific. That was fine. Well, for the Grand Ole Opry's newest friend, Miss Helen Trouble, I'd like to dedicate tonight's sacred song. And with the help of the Anita Kerr Singers, we'll do Robe of Calvary. Wear robes of gold and velvet, soon their glory fades away. But the King of Kings in heaven wore a homespun robe that day. Soldiers gambled for his garment, while the sun turned dark above. But the men who crucified him were forgiven by his love. His robe of Calvary, his robe in all its glory, will live eternally. His robe of Calvary, his robe in all its glory, will live eternally.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks, folks. Thanks a lot. Well, here comes a friend of ours with something mighty important on his mind.
Important? You bet it's important, George, especially to all the roll-your owners in our audience. It's about Prince Albert, America's largest selling smoking tobacco. Easy to roll, mild and tasty. PA makes wonderful smoking in an OCB paper.
Seems like more Macon's fans every day are finding out about the economy of PA Roll Your Own.
And about a flavor that really lasts due to PA's own special process, perfected over a period of nearly 50 years, that holds and heightens the aged-in mellowness of the choice tobacco. So roll up Prince Albert for your next Macon smoke, friends, and enjoy tobacco as nature meant tobacco to be.
Oh, roll your own with good PA. And take a puff or two. You'll get that extra smoking joy Prince Albert brings to you.
Now then, Miss Trouble, is there anything special you'd like to hear since we have the Southern hospitality carpet laid out for you?
Oh, yes, there is, George. I'm like every other gal, and I'm always interested in a little harmless gossip.
Yes, well, I'll tell you, we got the most harmless gossip in 48 states right here. Direct from Grinder Switch, Cousin Minnie Pearl. Here she comes.
Proud to be here tonight, and I sure want to meet that there Miss Helen Trouble, I'll declare.
Why, gal, down here in Tennessee, we don't stand on no ceremony. We just walks up and says, "Hiya, sugar. Glad to meet you."
The cutest thing I ever seen in my life. Well, sir, Miss Trouble, you being a great opera star, I'd like to get your opinion of my voice.
Oh, I'd love it.
Oh, I'm thinking of having a fling at that there high-class opera singing.
All right. Let me hear you sing this.
Oh. Well, good gracious alive. You mean like this?
Oh! Amazing. That's simply fantastic.
You ain't never heard nothing like that, have you? What do you think I could do with my voice, Miss Trouble?
Well, I think it would be wonderful in case of fire. But look, Minnie, let me give you a note. And I want you to sustain it.
To strain it?
No, no, Minnie. Sustain it. Give me a nice, pear-shaped tone like this.
You mean like this? Oh, no, I can't do that. A pear-shaped note.
Well, it started out like a pear, but it wound up more like a kumquat. Minnie, did you ever have a singing teacher?
Oh, yes, ma'am, I sure did. This year's singing teacher I've had said that I had a voice like a thrush or a nightingale or a mockingbird.
He told you yes. You had a voice like a thrush or a nightingale or a mockingbird?
And well, no, not in so many words. What he said was, Minnie, that voice of yours is strictly for the birds. And speaking of birds, I was a...
Howdy, Minnie. Howdy, Miss Trouble.
Why, it's you, Mr. Brasshead.
Brasshead?
Yeah. Minnie,
yes.
Rod was
was telling me before about his operatic career.
Well, maybe you might not know it, Miss Trouble, but Rodley here was responsible for the highest note ever reached in an opera house.
That's right.
You sang tenor, Rod?
No, ma'am. I was carrying the spear and the soprano backed into it.
Any kind of opera, you have to have a wide background.
A wide background? Well, I've got that. Well, I don't look so bad from the front, neither. Bye now.
Bless her heart, Minnie Pearl. Well, I tell you one thing. I know everybody listening is just as anxious to hear another song by Miss Helen Trouble as we are here at the Ryman. Aren't you folks one? That's fine. Come here and stand beside me, gal.
All right, Bella.
Which hoedown are you going to sing for us this time, gal?
Well, sir, this here is one I had the pleasure of recording some weeks back. Seems like y'all kind of like it, and I want to thank y'all for your fine cards and letters.
Oh, that's lovely, lovely.
George, this is a crazy little song called It May Be Silly, But Ain't It Fun? And I would love it if you and Rod and little Jimmy Dickens and Minnie Pearl would join with me in singing.
We'd love to. Let's
hear it. Oh, that's sweet.
Silly, but ain't it fun? It beats picture shows and carnivals all rolled up into one. You hug a while and you kiss a while and you say I love you. It may be silly, but ain't it fun?
No matter if it's 10 below or 90 in the shade, I'm always sitting ready when you're blowing through the main. My heart is just as frisky as a little poodle pup. So if you're looking for a kiss, I got one coming up. It may be silly, but ain't it fun? It beats picture shows and carnivals all rolled up in one. You hug a while, you kiss a while, you say I love you. It may be silly, but ain't it fun?
All right, Miss Trouble, it's your time.
Okay. One day I took my boyfriend on a visit to the zoo. Our monkey and his lady friend were busy pitching woo. He bit her on the ear and then he grinned a silly grin. I know what he was thinking as she smacked him on the chin.
It may be silly, but ain't it fun? It beats picture shows and carnivals all rolled up into one. You hug a while and you kiss a while and you say I love you. It may be silly, but ain't it fun?
Five-string banjo, and it looks like it's too late to stop him from singing. So go to it, boy.
I come and listen to my story, a story that I know is true. A little rose in blooming Georgia, will I have gold and a heart of true? Wait down in the blue mountain, wait down where the tall vine grows. Little sweetheart on the mountain, she's my little Georgie Rose. Lord, I feel so unnecessary.
Host of the evening,
George Morgan, has been so busy introducing us all that he hasn't had much chance to perform himself. So let me say that here is that fine young singer, George Morgan, singing his brand new record, I Think I'm Gonna Cry.
Thank you, Miss Helen. I love you. I will miss your schemes and your alibis now that I've told you goodbye. I don't want you to see the tears in my eyes. Please go now, I think I'm gonna cry. I'm sending you away, I just can't let you stay. I know that men shouldn't cry, but I've loved you for so long, and you've done me wrong. Please go now, I think I'm gonna cry. Don Davis? I'm sending you away, I just can't let you stay. I know that men shouldn't cry, but I've loved you for so long, and you've done me wrong. Please go now, I think I'm gonna cry.
Thank you.
So much. Well, that's that for tonight. And what a wonderful night it's been. Thanks to our very special guest, Miss Helen Trouble.
George, all the thanks goes to you and to Minnie Pearl and Rod for inviting me. I wouldn't have missed this for anything.
Oh, thank you. You're wonderful, and thank you for that kiss. Next week, we'll come calling for you in the buckboard, and the man in the driver's seat will be Hank Snow with the Carter sisters as his guest. So then, this is George Morgan saying, thanks for everything. We'll be seeing you next Saturday night at the Grand Ole Opry. Good night, everybody.
Feel that mildness. Yes, feel that mildness. Taste that flavor. That's a Cavalier.
Right. You don't just judge a cigarette's mildness or its flavor by what you hear. You judge by what you yourself feel and taste. That's why so many smokers are switching to king-size Cavaliers. Cavaliers are blended of fine, light, mild tobaccos by the makers of Camels. And you can tell how mild Cavaliers are by the way the smoke feels. So smooth, so light and easygoing. And friends, that's mildness where it counts. Mildness in the feel of the smoke as you inhale.
No wonder, when thousands of smokers compared Cavaliers with the cigarettes they'd been smoking, 8 out of 10 interviewed said Cavaliers are milder.
So light up and inhale. Feel that mildness. Yes, feel that mildness. Taste that flavor. That's a Cavalier.
And remember, Cavaliers are king size, yet priced no higher than leading regular size brands. So for extra length, extra value, at no extra cost, get a carton of Cavaliers.
This program was brought to you by WSM, affiliated with the National Broadcasting Company.